possibly hear. I mean, this is Daniel 12 and verse 1 of the same prophecy says, this is the worst time of suffering ever, ever on this earth. Here, I'll just read you a little from my Daniel booklet. In A.D. 70, when Roman armies were sweeping through the Middle East, they stopped just short of Jerusalem, surrounding it in effect. Just prior to Jerusalem's destruction, according to Jewish historian Josephus, there was a great earthquake. And the Jews heard the sound of a great multitude saying, let us remove hence. That's from the Wars of the Jews, volume 6 of Josephus. And I go on to write, upon hearing the warning, those who heeded quickly fled to Pella, a secluded mountainous location northeast of Jerusalem. That's where God's church went for protection. And that's where God protected them when all of these armies of the Roman Empire came flooding into Jerusalem. And I conclude here, all of this was just a type of what Jesus Christ said would happen again shortly before His second coming. So God is going to have to protect His people again. Protect them again. So he talks about in Daniel 11, verse 31, about this abomination of desolation. But in Daniel 11, verse 40, when he's talking about the king of the north, that is the abomination of desolation. And Christ Himself talked about that abomination in Matthew 24 and verse 15 and said that this is the abomination that's there in Jerusalem, surrounding Jerusalem. And He said it was spoken of by Daniel the prophet. And of course, that's what I'm reading to you today. If you look at the 21st chapter of Luke in verses 20 through 24, you'll see that Luke tells you what this abomination is. That's his version. And armies are surrounding Jerusalem, and God tells His people to get out of there and they will be protected before they come into that city and, frankly, double-cross the Jews. So that is what your Bible says is going to happen, and the first century was really only a type of what is going to happen in the last century. Notice verse 42 of Daniel 11. He shall stretch forth His hand also upon the countries, and the land of Egypt shall not escape. Again, we've been saying that for 20 years, that Egypt would be allied with the king of the south, and that's why the king of the north won't let him escape. He goes after those nations that were allied with the king of the south, or Iran, the Iranians. Verse 43, but He shall have power over the treasures of gold and of silver and over all the precious things of Egypt, and the Libyans and Ethiopians shall be at His steps. And the Sansino commentary says this about that statement, at His steps, either joining His army or placing themselves at His beck and call. So you need to watch Libya and Ethiopia. That includes Eritrea. They're on the coastline, and you're going to see them allying themselves with Iran. Gesenius Lexicon says when it talks about at His steps, it means in His footsteps or in His company. Or the Moffat says following in His train. So watch those two nations. Watch what is happening there. It's all happening before your eyes. And the king of the south is trying to get as much control of that trade route through the Red Sea and the Mediterranean Sea as he possibly can. And I talked to you about that 2 weeks ago and explained that to you. But somebody is going to have to stop the king of the south. Notice what happens. They are going to be stopped. Verse 44 talks about the tidings out of the east and the north. That's east is the Orient or the Orientals, China, and Japan probably, and then to the north, that's Russia. They're going to be troubled by what they hear is happening there. And then this king of the north is going to move to destroy or exterminate them, but they can't do it. And then you can see in verse 45, He shall plant the tabernacles of the palace between the seas in the glorious holy mountain, yet He shall come to His end and none shall help Him. That's actually the religious head. That talks about the tabernacles of His palace. This religious combine or this religious power has a throne as well, and it moves its headquarters to Jerusalem, which is probably its number one holy site anyhow, but still it doesn't work out well for them. This is not the political head of that king of the north. It's the spiritual head that it goes there and comes to its end right there in the glorious holy mountain. That's Mount Zion, where the temple is built. And then you can see the Daniel 12 and verse 4, a wonderfully good news there. And the commentaries will tell you that's where the vision ends, but it really doesn't. It goes on to the very end of this chapter. Verse 11 talks about the daily being taken away. In other words, the work of God is stopped. And that's when God takes His people, some of them anyhow, to a place of protection. And the abomination of desolation moves in. That's what it says there in verse 11. The abomination of desolation moves in. And in verse 12 says, blessed is he that waits for that 1290 days, the very period when Jesus Christ is going to return to this earth. Blessed are those people. That's the best news we could ever possibly hear. Jesus Christ is about to return, and He's going to conclude all of this. Until next week, this is Gerald Flurry. Goodbye, friends.
Today on The Key of David, Gerald Flurry spoke on the longest single prophecy in the Bible. To make this subject more clear, request our free booklets, History and Prophecy of the Middle East, Daniel Unsealed at Last, and a free DVD of today's program. The next time you read about peace in the Middle East, consider the facts. For over 4,000 years, the Middle East has been fraught with cultural, political, and religious violence. Much of this history is recorded in the history book almost no one relies on, the Holy Bible. And what makes the Bible so unique, compared to other historical accounts, is that it recorded much of this history before it occurred. These amazing prophecies of Daniel are unfolding on your nightly news. Make sure that you understand what your Bible reveals is about to happen next. Request our free booklets, History and Prophecy of the Middle East, Daniel Unsealed at Last, and a free DVD of today's program. You will also be sent a free subscription to our news magazine, The Philadelphia Trumpet. The Trumpet continues to help you understand your world by looking at today's most relevant headlines through the clear light of Bible prophecy. Please visit us online at thetrumpet.com for daily columns and videos. On thetrumpet.com, you will also have access to our Trumpet Forum videos. These presentations will help you understand the doctrines of your Bible. Forum videos are updated several times per week. Request our free booklets, History and Prophecy of the Middle East, Daniel Unsealed at Last, and a free DVD of today's program, along with the Trumpet Magazine. All our literature is free and will be sent to you with no cost or obligation. Order your free literature now. For the free literature, click on the Request Menu option.